All right, Lucario and Mewtwo. Forget what I said about Sceptile. All right. Anyway, so now this is the first time I've seen Lucario yet on stream. So
yeah,
let me see here. Oh, my, the classic Jirachi Lucario. I feel like I've been seeing that kind of go out of style as a play. I think most people are opting for Togekiss now.
Yeah.
I've seen.
Well, it's still a pretty solid choice.
Oh, yeah.
Still, yeah.
Because Lucario's burst is absolutely ridiculously powerful. Now, Zentropius really doing a good job just putting away at Lucario's health. Oh, very nice off right there.
Nice recognizing that the bone rush. He was doing the downward bone rush.
Yeah, there's a small amount of time on that swing where you can't punish it. Nice there, getting
nice
the grab. Now, Corbear doing a pretty good job with this energy right now. Has a good amount of it. Getting to a point where you get Jirachi, you'll be able to get over that limit. Right now, his health ain't looking too good, and so Tropius risking it all on that fire punch right there. If Corbear were to shield that, it would have been a very, very bad situation for him, because that is a very, very punishing move. Warbear has that Jirachi ready to go. He can use that again for whenever he needs it. Oh, Hyper Beam. Going out that charge Aura Sphere right there. It does leave Lucario very vulnerable.
Oh, getting that Fire Punch off.
Squeezes an absolutely insane amount of damage. Oh,
getting the counter.
Yeah, that, I was surprised that Aura Sphere usually they like to like charge that up a lot and then out like with just the same amount of like hitboxes. Robert does have that burst, he's gonna use it. Jirachi buff 386 can quickly be done by Lucario. Go for a tech grab actually, risking it all. Oh, here comes Fennekin. Oh, that's not gonna work. Yep, Fennekin will punish that. If that were other supports that did not allow this play, that would have been a good option, but Fennekin doesn't allow it. Absolutely insane amount there's a fire punch that blows. Not yet. Oh, wow.
Getting the 2-Y.
Yeah, so what Goldberg did there was actually he ducked under the cycle cut and beat out St. Tropius' approach there. Very smart right there. Recognize that. That is a high hitting out of risky approach. Now, Corbett does not have his burst to rely back on. Centrobius, though, getting really close to it. Oh, getting a very whiff punch. That is going to be a grab right there to beat it out. Corbett, keep up the pressure.
See him go for Jirachi, trying to build Savage Gate.
Yeah, yeah. Of course, Megafire is one of Lucario's greatest tools. Burst can be very, very, very dangerous.
Just fire punch.
Fire Punch is an insanely good command counter. I believe it is as quick as a regular counter, but its main downside is that it's very risky on shield. But the amount of damage it can bring is absolutely incredible. And St. Tropius is really, really making good use of it in this match. Nice 2-Y there. Goldberg can get his burst up. Alright. Well, this is a very serious situation. It's one hit for both players, and that counter there, snagging it for St. Tropius, winning game one right there. All right. Let's see. No changes, I think, from either player, by the looks of it. So this matchup, I feel like it's very, like, classic Pokken. Like, I think
yeah.
that both these characters really strive on, like, movement and fundamentals.
Yeah.
So it's just like both these characters are really embracing like, a lot about Pokken, like approaching and stuff like that,
yeah.
Projectiles.
It's a lot about just trying to get.
Yeah. Neither of these characters really have tools to effectively zone, so they.
Right.
But they also have tools where they can like play at distance. It's a lot of, like weaving in and out like at distance and like when to approach. It's cool, Brett. Oh, so what? What happens there is that you're not getting crit on Fire Punch. The second hit, the Ice Punch, is not actually true. So you're able to punish it and shield. Oh, hard call out there by Polar Bear. Oh, Force not working out there. Tropius is really, really doing a good job, though. punishing a lot of Bulbear's riskier options. Oh, and just like that, with a Hyper Beam, snagging so much damage. Alright, might be smart for Bulbear to use that Jirachi if he gets the same situation. That way, he can at least have the most energy in the next round, but I don't think he's gonna need it. Oh, Fennec in here.
Both players are looking extremely even right now.
Yeah, in general, this has been a very, very even match. Both players trading off a lot of stuff here. And that is a burst right there. But will it kill? I don't know. Jirachi boosted, Rage Scarlet. I don't know if that can do one damage.
I don't know.
Whoa, that is ridiculous. How did that kill?
Too much damage.
But anyway, so now, Polar Bear in a nice situation. He's gonna need to. He is down one game right now. Nice there with Psycho Cut. Again, like weaving in and out of like being in your face now. That's really about what both these characters are about.
Getting the JY control.
Nice amount of damage. And it was a force bomb. Over it again.
Nice catching on the vulnerability.
Yeah, even though St. Trophies did go for a fire punch, force bomb, just how many hitboxes it has can easily snag one of the things on the now. So there's a side strike right there. I couldn't tell if that was a just fight or not. I didn't get the sound.
I don't think so. Okay.
I can't even tell if there would be a sound.
Yeah. It just darkens.
Oh, yeah.
Frames.
Right. Ooh, again, there's another fire punch there. Kohler might be one to think about using his burst right now. Bit of a tight situation. St. Trophy is trying to bait something out right now. Yeah. Like maybe like a risky bone rush, maybe Aura Sphere and Hyper Beam it.
Both players should play safe until.
Okay, actually, I just realized something right there. St. Trophy actually used his high stance there for a second. Actually, was able to get enough burst to get him over the edge right there. That was actually very smart when he was trying to bait something out like that. Alright, nice Aura Sphere. Snag that victory right there. Now, Polar Bear taking this to game three right now. Alright, so. You used to play a lot of Lucario, right? Like, or just a little bit?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, do you have any opinions on this matchup or anything like that?
Not really, it's pretty even from what I've seen.
Yeah, I know what definitely looks like it too. Both these characters are just like very, very strong and neutral, like that's really what they really focus on. So a lot of like poking around, trying to find an option right and like trying to punish it.
Oh,
we're getting a character change. Okay, we're getting Empoleon now. Alright, alright. St. Trophy is pulling out a new character. So let's see how this works out. So of course, as we saw from Nexus earlier, Empoleon is definitely a very brute force kind of character. So if he can get in, really, really strong damage now. Sticking to the Fennekin support, which kind of seems a little bit counteractive. Like, because usually Empoleon really wants to stay in close, but Fennekin kind of does not allow that, of course, in the way. So I'm not sure how I feel about that support, unless Empoleon has a hard time getting pressure off.
I could see it.
Yeah.
No, but
I think overall, like, something like Eevee would be a better option, I think. Yeah. Really helping out that damage. St. Trophy's really trying to hit some. Heads up with these ice beams, trying to confirm off of them. Ooh, nice punish by Polar Bear. Oh, man. Hit must have been in the air.
There's the Fennekin.
Right, so I guess that's St. Trophy's really feels that will really help him out with King Rip Pressure. I think that's the main use of it.
Yeah.
I can kind of see, but I think there could be better support for him. Oh, very nice to call out the edge. I don't follow up off of him though. Oh, is he gonna get it again? No, very, very likely. I think it's like frame 27 when he's checking out. Now, first Lucario, first round here, and that is gonna snag right there. Bone Rush beating out projectiles. St. Trophies might be regretting this this character change right now. Having a hard time getting him.
Yeah, I think he's having a hard time just figuring out where he should apply pressure.
Yeah, I think that's definitely, he's definitely like testing on water, but not getting much off of it.
Yeah.
Although, there we go, he gets the defense down, and a grab there to do it. However, Empoleon's grab is not very powerful on its own. Most of the damage came because of that defense debuff from Rock Smash.
Yeah.
He is sitting at no damage yet, so might be fighting something right now. It's Polar Bear, he's there, and goes for a grab right there. St. Trophy does have his burst at the ready, but I don't think now would be a good time. He's still too working with what he has.
Gets him with the sidewalk.
Alright, so Polar Bear getting close to this place, so he's gonna use it the second he can get it. He already has Jirachi ready to go. Nice Fennekin over there. Get him away. Actually against the wall as well. Ooh, Ooh, Goldberg getting a nice combo off right now. Letting Sing Sogi's in rage.
Oh, trying to ice beam through it, but it didn't come out of time.
Oh yeah, it's very, very slow.
Uh-huh.
But if it was, if it wasn't, then it'd be pretty ridiculous.
Yeah.
Nice, nice back Y right there. Oh, scary situation. Right. And that is gonna hit right there. That is gonna do it right there. So Empoleon's burst is a grab. I think that's gonna be the but it is definitely the worst. Even though it has a one a hitbox behind it, it still has no visibility on activation. So it can be really, really risky option. But it did work out for St. Tropius. However, he did have to spend his burst to do it. Pretty strong right now. It's a nice name drop right now. And then with the force palm. Oh, drill peg. That's an interesting option right there.
See him going for first palm on wake up.
Yeah. Over again. Getting a little bit predictable right now.
See some damage here, though.
Did scale quite heavily, but damage is damage at this point.
He's in rage right now, so
Burst did come out of that, but not too far off from it. This is where Burst Napoleon is really, really scary.
Uh-huh.
Peck, some nice damage right now.
Nice
not approaching with Ice Beam. I think he should be doing a lot more of the slides to get in like that.
There you go.
Worked out. And there's a grab right there, and that is going to do it. St. Tropius taking out Polar Bear in a very, very close set right there. 2-1. Yeah, that was very close. A bit of a risky grab right there, but it worked out in his favor, snagging that victory.